it. You can put it on the board.
Welcome to the Sports Circus. I'm your Ringmaster Sal, live from Las Vegas in the AMP TV studio, AAMP.TV. Today's show is brought to you by UppercutChops.com. Check out their tasty selection of all-natural, dry-aged USDA Prime Angus and Wagyu steaks and chops. Wait till you see their best-in-class New York steaks, the filet mignons, and of course, the king of all, those big cowboy cut and tomahawk ribeyes. And of course, the Angus and Wagyu burgers will probably be the best you've ever had as well. Shop from the comfort of your own home. Check them out online at UppercutChops.com, UppercutChops.com, or call for more information at 702-799-9935, 702-799-9935. Again, 702-799-9935 for UppercutChops.com. All right, a big welcome to everybody listening in on our CBS, NBC, and Fox Sports affiliates from coast to coast. Magic 97.9 FM right here in Las Vegas. Cox, Comcast, Spectrum, Frontier, Wild Cable affiliates, as well as hotel television in over 500,000 rooms from coast to coast. You know, we have a very unique and special guest today. In fact, we're going to let him introduce himself. Go ahead.
Oh, my name is Jay Carrigan. How you doing there, Sal?
Yes, I'm doing great. Yes.
Oh, awesome. I'm glad to be here, man. Thanks so much for having me.
Jay, what do you do?
So I do coffee, and I have a,
live stream. He doesn't drink coffee. He does coffee. Go ahead.
I do coffee. And so we have a coffee shop here, a coffee company here in Baltimore, Maryland, called Spro Coffee. And then on YouTube, I do coffee videos and live streams about coffee and cigars.
Coffee and cigars. How do you like that? Yeah. The two things that I like the very least, but we have to talk about it because most of the world drinks coffee except me. Okay. Many of the people, men and women, they like to smoke cigars, not me. So this is going to be kind of interesting. But nonetheless, we have a couple of bits of housekeeping to get out of the way first, because we have to talk a little bit, because you're in the Baltimore area. Of course, we have to talk something that has to do with the Preakness. How about this?
Oh, yes,
how about the idea? You know, we had a Kentucky Derby winner. We don't want to timestamp the show because we want to be able to use this again. Right. So, listen, folks, it's live. Anything could happen. But how about this? How about Kentucky Derby champion Rich Strike? What a wild and unbelievable race that was, right?
Oh, my gosh, amazing.
Rich Strike, buddy, listen to this. Rich Strike will not run in the Preakness.
Oh, really? I didn't know that.
But wait, remember, everything's a business decision. So according to CBS Sports, the chase for the Triple Crown will have to wait another year. And Rich Strike, the surprise long shot winner of the Kentucky Derby, will not compete in the Preakness next week. And in fact, instead, Rich Strike is going to wait for the Belmont Stakes.
Oh, man.
It's a money decision and nothing more. How embarrassing. Nonetheless, the decision for trainer Eric Reed and owner Rick Dawson came down to what was best for history versus what was best for the horse. Prior to the Miracle Derby finish, Rich Strike's team had planned to compete at the Belmont and bypass the Preakness. And it was only the weight of history that kept the race at Pimlico in the horse's future at all. Hey, listen, you know, here's the crazy thing. Listen, if you got a chance to win the Triple Crown, which is the holy grail of horse racing, how the hell do you not take that shot? Oh, we were going to pass up the Preakness anyway. Yeah, because you're an 80-1 shot and you weren't supposed to win until they scratched the number 20 horse and gave you more room out the gate. We'll get back to that. Quote, after very careful consideration, the owner and trainer of Rich Strike felt it was not the best interest of the horse to run in the Preakness, and we look forward to returning in the Belmont. Yeah, so the course of booze continues. So, Jay, I'm going to finish this one up here in a minute because you're in Baltimore where they have the Preakness, and it yes. is a glorious episode. Nonetheless, the Belmont Stakes sets up as a better course for Rich Strike's strengths. Of course, a mile and a half, that's the longest out of all of the Triple Crown races. And, of course, opposed to the Preakness, a mile and 3/16. And the Derby's a mile and a quarter, giving Rich Strike more opportunity to close in the way it did at Churchill Downs when that late rush at the very end of the race, and it was crazy how it just overtook the others. Nonetheless, the turns at Pimlico are tighter, though. Now, this is fact. Mm-hmm. They are tighter, which is strange because, remember, it's a bigger course than Churchill. Nonetheless, this is an issue. So it makes for more traffic and more potential for trouble horses tripping over one another and jockeys falling off, getting trampled, whatnot. But the furious record-setting pace that began at the Derby, which tired out the favorites in the late part of the race, is unlikely to be repeated, of course. And finally, in terms of the horse's health, Rich Strike has never raced more than once in 5 weeks, and the Preakness would have added a race in the middle of that five-week period between the Derby and the Belmont Stakes. But you know, Jay, we are absolutely being robbed of the possibility of history. Imagine an 80-1 shot winning the Derby. Maybe he'll go off at 20-1 or whatnot in the Preakness, and maybe at 20-1 or whatnot in the Belmont Stakes. But now, right there in Baltimore, we're going to get cheated out of the Preakness with the possibility of a Triple Crown winner.
But we're just always getting disrespected here in Baltimore. That's the problem with the world.
Okay. So you think you're being disrespected? What about your football team?
Oh, our football team, our football team is pretty solid, I think, overall. I think baseball, unfortunately, we're not too good in that realm. Hey,
now hold that thought, because the Baltimore Orioles are playing very good ball. In fact, the Orioles are not in last place. It is. Are you ready for this? The Boston Red Sox in last place.
Well, that's okay. That's okay.
Right. All right. So let's think about this. All right. So now we got this horse race out there. You know, we think of the pageantry between, you know, all the people that are out there, like at the Derby, right? They're all wearing the women are wearing these big dress. The guys are wearing these zoot suits or whatever the hell they wear. And what do they have? They've got cigars. What would be the most popular cigar at one of these big races of the Triple Crown?
Oh, I think probably the Perdomo cigar would be one of the more popular ones there.
And why is that?
It's just one of these cigars that's very accessible to a lot of people, and the price points are usually very good. And just the accessibility of flavor is easy to manage for most people.
Okay, so I'm a guy that I've never smoked a cigar. I've only smelled them, right?
Okay.
So I know zero about cigars, just like coffee. But let's stick with cigars right now. As a rookie cigar smoker, for all those people out there listening and watching right now that don't smoke cigars, maybe they want to try it. Maybe they say, hey, it's a cool thing. My friends do it. How can I get involved? What should they be looking for? And what price points can they expect from the highs and lows?
Well, the nice thing about the cigars is that you can find cigars in most any price point, ranging from like $5 to $6 up until $100, $150 for one stick. It's really amazing in that respect when they get to that point. But the ability for people to get really nice cigars at a low price point is very accessible. It's very possible. Okay, so I would say look for something a little bit more mild, on the mild, like this one called the Camacho Ecuador is kind of a mild cigar that I think is very accessible to people.
What was the name of that again?
It's called Camacho.
Camacho.
Yes.
And it's out of Ecuador.
It has an Ecuadorian wrapper, which is why they call it Ecuador.
Oh, okay. Kind of like bananas, right? We have a lot of bananas from Ecuador, but now we also have cigars there from as well. Okay. All right. So are these expensive cigars? Are they, I mean, what is it that makes a cigar so expensive?
Well, a lot of times when you get to the expensive cigars, of course, they're using tobacco that is very well cultivated. Like, for example, they're aging cigar tobacco for sometimes 2 to 4, 5, 6, 7 plus years. Before they actually will utilize it. Once it's utilized and rolled into a cigar, a really great manufacturer will then rest that cigar and age it again, sometimes up to 2 years.
So it's like the fine wine idea. Or at the top of the show, what do we have? We had uppercutchops.com, right? Exactly. So we had dry aged beef, right? Dry aged prime Wagyu beef. So it's the same idea, but this is like the holy grail of cigars, right?
That's right. Just like with the prime aged beef from Uppercut, that when the longer you age a cigar to a cigar tobacco, like the beef, it matures and just becomes something greater than it started.
Okay, so what is the maximum that you can really age a cigar for before maybe it goes sideways on you?
Well, here's the thing. It's one of those things where we've done aging of cigars. And now that I've been involved with it for such a long time, I have cigars that we've aged for like 20 plus years.
And really?
It's really, as long as you keep them in the right conditions, you can age them for a very long time. Now, you will find that some cigars will go through periods of like troughs. So there's great periods of great flavor, and then they'll kind of become dormant for maybe a year or 2 years, and then they'll rise again. And that's the kind of pattern I found with aging cigars.
That's unbelievable. Here in our last 30 seconds of a segment, I'm trying to wrap my head around this, because you think of, all right, well, maybe it's going for a certain amount of time. And you're saying, you know, it's kind of like the dark ages of a cigar, right? So it goes through some really bad times, but then it rebounds and comes back. I can't even understand how that happens biologically. That's just above my pay grade. But I think it's fascinating, because I wonder if wine actually goes through the same thing.
I believe it does. I believe it does. Like with the really fine, like reds, like from France and from California, they go through similar periods of dormancy.
Really? That's, you know what? When we come back from break, I want to hear a little bit more about that. Because, buddy, I got to tell you, I'm in the sporting world, the entertainment world, but I know zero about this. And I think this is good for the audience, because they get to, I guess, light up. If they don't light up, they can light up here on commercial break coming up right here. And they can do a little bit of research themselves. You've got just a few minutes, folks. We're going to be back here with Jake Carrier from Coffee and Cigars right here on the Sports Circus. Don't go anywhere. Last one to go.
Nobody wants to get ripped off, broken into, or robbed, but nobody wants to pay a lot of money to have their home protected either. I've got an offer to tell you about to provide home security for your home for less than a dollar a day. For real. With no installation or equipment charges. And this is from a company rated number one by a leading consumer research company. According to the facts, most of you won't even call unless there's a burglary in your neighborhood or something bad happened. So let's give you a reason. Save money. For less than a dollar a day with no other costs, you can get your home secured. Plus, get a lifetime equipment replacement warranty. You need protection for your home. Call the home security hotline right now.
800-361-3491. 800-361-3491. 800-361-3491. Again, that's 800-361-3491.
AMP, the multi-format network, is here to help create, produce, distribute, and sell your content. For more information, send a message to info@aamp.tv. That's info@aamp.tv.
Are you a small business owner or pursuing the dream of starting your own company? Do you know where to start or how to grow that existing business? The American Business Trust Company has the answers you need. The American Business Trust Company can help you with startup capital, business strategy, sales and marketing, and establishing your company with a physical location or on the internet. You decide. You bring the idea. The American Business Trust Company can help with the rest. For a free evaluation, you may visit them online at abtrustco.com. That's abtrustco.com, or call them at 657-600-1876. That's the American Business Trust Company, 657-600-1876. Call them today. They can help your business right away.
Come on. You watch the news. Be prepared to pay more taxes. Then if you owe back taxes or haven't filed in a few years, get ready. The IRS, the largest collection agency in the world, will be coming after you. With the power to collect taxes by any means they want to. Hey, they can freeze your bank account, your passport, even padlock your business. Oh, good times. Look, if the IRS claims you owe them $5,000 or more in back taxes and they're coming after you, don't panic. Call my friends at Get a Tax Lawyer first. Their job is to negotiate with the IRS and save you money. They're experts at it. That's all they do. And you can trust them. In some cases, they have reduced a $50,000 tax bill to less than $1,000. If you owe the IRS $5,000 or more in back taxes, call now for a free consultation.
800-908-7016. 800-908-7016. 800-908-7016. That's 800-908-7016. We'll be right back.
Welcome back to the Sports Circus. I'm your Ringmaster Sal, live from Las Vegas in the Amp TV studio, AAMP.TV. This segment brought to you by our friends over at the Wynn Hotel, and it is Delilah. Delilah at Wynn Las Vegas offers a true supper club atmosphere inspired by the earliest showrooms in Las Vegas back in the 1950s. The venue has multiple environments for guests to dine and socialize with live music and special performances, DJs, and Sunday night jazz. Described as, quote, modern decor harkens back to Hollywood's golden era. Plush banquets are softly illuminated by dripping chandeliers, globe lanterns, and candlelight, creating a romantic Gatsby-esque vibe. Close quote. Now that's pretty impressive. In fact, make your reservations at Delilah at the Wynn Las Vegas at Delilah@WynnLasVegas.com. That's Delilah@WynnLasVegas.com, folks. This is one of the most unique dining experiences you'll ever have. In fact, it's right here in Las Vegas. Make sure you check them out at Wynn Las Vegas, and that is Delilah. All right, a big welcome in to everybody listening in on our CBS, NBC, and Fox Sports affiliates from coast to coast, including our friends over in Honolulu on CBS Sports 1500 KHKA. That's home of the 49ers, the New York Yankees, and the Alabama Crimson Tide. Big welcome in to everybody in Southern California, NBC News, CNBC Financial, right here in Las Vegas, Magic 97.9 FM, right around the corner from the Fremont Street Experience, over in Faraday, Louisiana, Natchez, Mississippi, 107.1 The River. Thanks for tuning in, Mid-South Broadcasting, as well as WAUD over in Auburn, Alabama, home of the world champion Atlanta Braves. And speaking of Atlanta, WDJY 99.1 FM, and everybody else watching on Cox, Comcast, Spectrum, Frontier, Well Cable affiliates, and hotel television, and everybody else on the Mars rover. Thanks for joining us. We are here with a very special guest, and that would be Jay Carrier of Coffee and Cigars. In the last segment, Jay, we're talking a little bit about cigars and what makes them so expensive. And we're actually talking about the aging part, the dry aging part. I had no idea that there could be this aging process. Go ahead and refresh everybody and expand on that, would you?
Well, so the aging of cigars, once you have a cigar and you can age them in the right temperature and environment. So basically you want to have it what we call 70-70, 70 degrees Fahrenheit, 70% humidity is the ideal combination to age your cigars. And over time, they can improve and mature. Sometimes they will get a little bit more mellow and more blended together as far as the flavors, but other times they just become really, really extraordinary.
So what makes a cigar extraordinary? I have to say this because I don't smoke cigars, but what makes one stand out? Like this one is the holy grail of cigars versus, I don't know, the Walmarts or whatever of cigars.
Perhaps the best way to describe that is if we think of a sports player, right? The best of sports players have a really wonderful combination of talents, right? It's not just the ability to just, you know, dribble the ball or throw the ball. They have to have everything together, coordination. They have to be able to work with their teammates and really inspire them. Cigars is kind of like that, where you have a combination of flavors that come together in a synergy that is greater as a whole than the individual components.
Okay. All right. I feel you on that. And look, this, for example, for what he's talking about, folks, is maybe a five-tool player in baseball, right? They could run, hit, they could catch, they could do this, they could do that, whatever, right? So it's an all-around better player. In this case, it's an all-around better cigar, is what you're saying.
Yes, absolutely. Absolutely.
Okay. And so how does the amateur cigar aficionado, how do they really learn what's better and what's not? Is it just a matter of taste or all the bloodlines, so to say, like we have in horse racing? Is it one of those, you know, it's better because of this checklist?
Well, I think it's one of those things where, you know, it can be that, you know, it's better because of its bloodline and the checklist. But in order for you to really get into it and really experience that the best, I think it takes a little bit of time smoking a range of cigars, learning the flavors that you appreciate on your own personal palate. And then eventually you find cigars that are just like, that just speak to you and just are like fantastic. You're like, oh my gosh, this is a flavor combination that's just unbelievable.
Right. And you know, it's kind of a similar thing to the amateur champagne buyer, right? Or sparkling wine. So let's say you go to Joe Blow liquor store and you say, well, hey, you know, maybe I want to get a bottle of champagne for a special night or a bottle of sparkling wine, and I'm not really sure what to do. So how do we judge that? In many cases, you can go to these liquor stores and you can pick up your favorite bottle or whatever and reach underneath there, look underneath, and you see how deep the cone is. Right. So you kind of, it's like a cheat sheet for those bottles. But is there a cheat sheet for cigars?
Well, there, I would say there is kind of a cheat sheet. Like you could, there's certain brands that you can choose that tend to offer really nice quality flavors across their entire spectrum of offerings. I think that's probably the best analogy to the cone inside a champagne bottle.
Yeah. I mean, it's the only thing I could really think of to give some kind of parallel for the average person out there that really doesn't know anything about cigars. And of course you talk about cigars on air, and what's the name of your program?
It's called Coffee and Cigars on the Ono Live channel on YouTube.
The Ono Live as in the Ono kind, if you know what I mean, right?
That's exactly it. That's exactly all it. Right.
That's good stuff. That's good stuff. And how often do people get a chance to watch you broadcast?
So we broadcast live at 8 p.m. Eastern every Thursday.
All right. Where can they find you?
On the Ono Live channel on YouTube is the best place to find us.
All right. Go ahead and tell everybody or spell that out for all those people that can't write or they can't remember.
It's Ono, O-N-O. Live, L-I-V-E. Just punch that into the YouTube search and it'll pull you right up to that channel. And you can join us every Thursday at 8 p.m. Eastern.
Gotcha. The Ono Kind Grinds.
Ono Kind Grinds.
Oh, that's good stuff. So you have a little Hawaiian in you, am I hearing some Pacific Islander in there somewhere?
Well, my family is from the Philippines, but I lived in Honolulu for about 8 years. And, you know, once you live there for a while, it just becomes part of you. And so Ono is a great way. So the main channel that I work with on YouTube is called Ono Coffee. So delicious coffee. Ono meaning delicious in Hawaiian. And it just kind of sprung from there. So when we wanted to create a live show, we decided to call it Ono Live to tie in.
Well, you know, the Ono fish is like what we have here on the mainland.
Yes.
Right. We think of the Wahoo fish, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. Right. So, I mean, for me, I love Wahoo's Fish Tacos. I get no money for saying this, folks. I just love the place. And I've been going to Wahoo's Fish Tacos for 35 years thereabouts. I think it's been about 35 years.
Awesome.
So that absolutely deserves a round of applause. But the food is good. It's a different kind of thing. It's like a Baja California kind of grinds, and it's not deep fried and everything is charbroiled. It's all good, man. Really good stuff. So over on the East Coast, now you've got all the crab over there. So is there a cigar with crab, a good match? What do you think?
Wow, that's really a great, I would think that here in the East Coast, which is very different than the West Coast Dungeness style crab, here we steam the crabs with a lot of this spicy blend of seasonings called Old Bay. So it's got this kind of distinct spice and bite to it, which I've never actually thought
about. Come on, you got to pair the blue crab with a cigar.
I think that I would go with something on the milder side so that it's not really competing too heavily with the flavor of the spicy crab. That would be something maybe like what's called the Drew Estate Undercrown Shade would probably be my choice for that.
Gotcha. It's like when you're pairing food and wine, for example, right? I mean, you certainly don't put the wrong kind of food with the wrong kind of wine. If you're going to have like a chicken or poultry, as I understand it, from the wine drinking world, you'd typically have like a white wine, would you not? And if you're having some beef type of product or whatever, something heavier like that, then maybe you pair it with a red wine. That's what I understand. I've been to a bunch of vineyards. And what have I done? I've eaten some grapes, but I've not really drank the wine because I'm just not a wine drinker, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, it happens. I mean, you're Sicilian, right? And you don't drink wine?
Oh, hell no.
Oh, my goodness.
And you know what? And I don't cook. Listen, yes, cooking is a sport, I guess. Apparently, this is a sports show, by the way, folks. The fact is, I do cook, but some people say I'm the worst cook in the world, of course, which you know, I think is a bunch of BS. There's only one person I know that's ever said that. And most other people have said I'm a pretty good cook. But at the same time, I cook with a fair amount of garlic. I don't go bananas with it. Just because you're making an Italian dish doesn't mean you have to put gobs and gobs and gobs of garlic in it, because garlic does not equal Italian. Garlic is just happened to be a spice in there, if you know what I mean.
Yes. Yeah. Well, I think that in most of Italy, they don't really use much garlic. Like in the north, it's only really in the south that they use a lot of garlic, correct?
Well, if they're making like an arrabbiata or something mm-hmm. like that, the spicy kind of stuff, yeah, you're going to see there's a fair amount in it, but there's actually a lot more of the cheese in there, right? The pungent cheeses, like the Romano cheese, which in our kitchen, in our refrigerator growing up, we never called it Romano cheese. We always knew it as smelly cheese. Actually, go get the smelly cheese because it was so strong. Right. But a lot of people like to load up the Parmesan. I had a deep dish the other day or yesterday with a good friend of mine. And they had a little jar of it on the table. And I said, I'll tell you what, Taylor, take that jar of the Parmesan and move it over to your side. But whatever you do, don't put it on anything until you have a slice of the deep on your plate and then let it snow on top of there. Oh, otherwise, that horrific taste is going to be throughout the entire pizza. And my pizza experience would have been absolutely ruined.
So, well, does that mean that you're not a fan of New Haven pizza?
Excuse me?
You know, the pizzas in New Haven, they use a lot of the Romano, the Pecorino Romano on their pizzas.
I know, it's too strong. I'll tell you what, let's talk pizza and cigars, and we'll even get into coffee, like the after-dinner coffee stuff, the cappuccinos and whatever, when we come back for the break with Jay Carrigy of Coffee and Cigars right here on the Sports Circus. Don't go anywhere. Lots more to come.
Attention business owners, you and your customers are listening to this commercial right now. Face it, every business needs customers, even yours. The Sports Circus is a primetime nationally syndicated program that's carried on ABC, NBC, CNBC, and Westwood One News affiliates, plus CBS, Fox, and NBC Sports affiliates across North America with coverage from Hawaii to New York. Also, the Sports Circus is available to the 180 million subscribers on iHeartRadio, and the Sports Circus gets about 4 million website visitors per month, which could click through your website and bring sales. The Sports Circus provides great content featuring celebrity guests from sports and entertainment to our audience every weekday, which your company could greatly benefit from by increasing your visibility, foot traffic, eyeballs to your website, and calls from potential customers. Call us right now at 702-799-9935. Again, 702-799-9935, or email us at info@thesportscircus.com. That's info@thesportscircus.com. Drive your sales today by advertising with the Sports Circus.
Nobody wants to get ripped off, broken into, or robbed, but nobody wants to pay a lot of money to have their home protected either.
I've got an offer to tell you about to provide home security for your home for less than a dollar a day. For real, with no installation or equipment charges. And this is from a company rated number one by a leading consumer research company. According to the facts, most of you won't even call unless there's a burglary in your neighborhood or something bad happened. So let's give you a reason. Save money. For less than a dollar a day with no other costs, you can get your home secured. Plus, get a lifetime equipment replacement warranty. You need protection for your home. Call the home security hotline right now.
800-361-3491. 800-361-3491. 800-361-3491. Again, that's 800-361-3491.
So, you want to be in show business. Do people tell you that you're really funny, you have a great personality, and you should have your own talk show? Many of us have been told that, but we don't know how to get started. It's easier than you think. Let the pros at Cali Vegas give you a free talent evaluation. Call 949-445-1119 and learn how quickly you can create, produce, and host your very own talk show. Imagine not having to sit in traffic every day, commuting back and forth to the same old boring job. Get started in television or radio today with your free talent evaluation from Cali Vegas. Call 949-445-1119 or visit them online at calivegas.com. Make your dream come true today and create your new career and learn how to become a television or radio star with the help of Cali Vegas. 949-445-1119. Call now.
Yeah.
Welcome back to the Sports Circus. I'm your Ringmaster Sal, live from Las Vegas in the AMP TV studio, AAMP.TV. This segment brought to you in part by our friends over at Sumo Light, providing all of our professional lighting right here in Las Vegas, and of course on movie sets and big concert stages and whatnot across the country and around the world. German company, sumolight.com. Check them out. Award-winning company, two-time award winner at the National Association of Broadcasters Convention right here in Las Vegas. The best of the best, sumolight.com. Check them out, sumolight.com. Yes! All right, welcome back to everybody. You know who you are. Everybody streaming. We're here with Jay Carrigay of Coffee and Cigars. We left off. Somehow we got into food and garlic and this and that. And I said, you know, let's think about this. Yes, it is competition. People do compete for food, right? This is a sports show, nonetheless. So hey, you said that like, well, yeah, absolutely. Like Rocky, right?
Absolutely. We even compete in coffee.
I want to get to that in just a second. All right. So let's talk about real quick the idea of really strong food, like really heavy, like an arrabbiata, like the spicy sauce in Italian. So you have the cappellini alla arrabbiata, right? So that's the angel hair pasta with the spicy sauce, maybe with some shrimp or something in there. Really good stuff, right?
Yes.
But a lot of times it's really powerful, garlicky. Wow. What do you do from a cigar standpoint? Do you choose a milder, more mild cigar with something like that as your after-dinner cigar?
With something like an arrabbiata, man, I think, you know, like I know in the last segment I talked about with crabs and the spiciness of the crab, I would go with something more mild, but something an arrabbiata, I think I'd want a cigar that would stand up to it.
Really?
So something, yeah, I think that would be really stand much more fight. Interesting. Yeah, exactly. So something that'd be really like on top of it. There's this one cigar that I really enjoy called the Revenge from a company called Roma Craft Cigars down in Austin, Texas. And I think that would be really, really awesome together with something like an arrabbiata.
Okay, so now this is conflicting because remember, I am the non-cigar guy, right?
Right.
We'll get to coffee in a second. So as the non-cigar guy, I just heard something about, well, let's get something that's not going to combat the taste of something else so strong. Like, so we think about the early conversation we had, but now you're saying, all right, now we're going to let the cigar and the food kind of duke it out for your taste buds.
Yeah, I don't know if it's necessarily duking it out, but more like in the previous example, it's a cigar that's milder so that it doesn't necessarily compete and overshadow the spiciness of the crab. But in this case, with that arrabbiata, I think I'd want something a little bit more stronger, a little more spicy to kind of complement instead of contrast.
Really?
Yeah. I think that
would
be
much more exciting. You know what, to me, here's what it sounds like to me. It's like, you have smokers out there. They like to have their after dinner smoke, whatever, right? A cigarette, right? Just to stick with that. I don't smoke, so it doesn't matter to me. But I noticed that a lot of people that smoke, I have family members, they like to light up after they have a meal in the same light that other people that may not necessarily smoke, they like to have maybe a cappuccino or something like that after, or their espresso, whatever the hell it is. One of those little cups. They like to have some kind of coffee taste to replace the taste of the food or whatever, to get right back into their groove. Now, do cigar smokers do the same thing?
Oh, absolutely. Especially after a big meal, like we were talking earlier, especially if there's a big steak meal going on, like one of the best ways to cap that off is with a nice, fine quality cigar after the meal.
But what about the pre-meal cigar? Is there a pre-meal cigar?
I think
like
for the
pre-game, post-game.
Like for the most hardcore, like, but here's the difference. So like, a lot of people that smoke cigars are really doing it more for enjoyment, relaxation, and flavor rather than stimulation that cigarette smokers would be going for. Cause you know, cigarette smokers have that nicotine that they want to soothe their nerves. And it's a completely different experience with cigars.
How so?
So with cigars, it's really about the flavor of the cigar. So typically, you'll find you really don't see cigar smokers out in the cold, standing on the side of the street, trying to get a quick puff to help soothe their nerves. What you really find cigar smokers doing is after a meal or at the end of the day, they're sitting back relaxing, leaning back, having a cigar, enjoying the flavor. And then really, most importantly, it's about having community and commune with people that are like-minded. So you can sit down and talk and just enjoy yourself for like that hour and a half or so.
Okay. So let's take this to the beginning of the day. When people wake up, I see this all the time, social media posts, I've got to have my coffee, right? So people go bananas by having their coffee, whatever the hell that means, right? They've got to have a certain kind of coffee. Again, I don't drink coffee. So what is it? Is it the same idea with the cigarette and the nicotine, with the coffee and the caffeine? Is that what we're talking about here?
Absolutely. It really, in many respects, is about addiction and feeding that addiction. Because you have a lot of coffee drinkers who, if they don't get their morning coffee, they end up with this caffeine headache because they're missing it. And so they have this physical reaction to not having the caffeine. And so that's why
they become chemically imbalanced, is what you're saying, temporarily.
Essentially, yes.
Really? But what about the after dinner little cup of coffee, whatever the heck?
I think a lot of times it's kind of like a digestive kind of thing, where you're drinking coffee just to kind of help settle the stomach, especially after a larger meal. You just want something that's going to help soothe it along. And also coffee can be a great accompaniment to sweet desserts as well.
Well, right. If I think there's that tiramisu that's sitting out there, that's that coffee flavor. But what about all the other desserts out there? Does the coffee interfere with the flavor of anything non-tiramisu like?
No, I think that in a lot of respects, you have things, let's say like a lot of what's a popular dessert would be like a chocolate cake of some sort or something that has chocolate in it, right? A lot of the flavors in a typical coffee tend to complement the flavor of chocolate and things like that. And so that's kind of, I think, where it comes in to play with a lot of people after their meals.
Okay. All right. Well, now what about the different strengths of coffee? Since we're on coffee, let's just go with that for a minute.
Okay. So the different strengths are out there. It's one of those things where if you're at a restaurant, like you don't normally have a lot of choices. So typically the restaurants will go for a little bit more bolder. I just think it's because a lot of the people that run restaurants don't know any better. They don't know how to find nice quality coffee to really set them apart and end the meal in a way that ends with an exclamation point rather than just a period.
So that's a good way to say it. So you're the coffee and cigar aficionado type, but how did you get so wound and driven into this? We'll just talk about the coffee since we're there right now. Did it just speak to you? Did it sing to you and say, give me coffee? I must have coffee.
Well, over 20 years ago, before I got into the business, I was very much like you. I didn't drink coffee. I didn't like coffee. I couldn't stand it. But situations came about where I decided that I was going to get into the coffee business on a cafe level. And I have this kind of personality where if I'm getting involved and I want to get involved at the highest level, like I want to find the best quality possible and be recognized as amongst the best that we can be. So I fell in this rabbit hole with some mentors that were very much into that as well, and just got sucked into this world of high-end specialty coffee. And so that's really where we've kind of spent most of the last 20 years.
So in 20 years, you just kind of morphed into a coffee guru.
Right. Exactly.
Nice. Well, look, I mean, I wasn't even planning on doing what I do here. It just kind of happened. And just like with you, it sounds like it just kind of happened. But you made a business decision, as did I, with this, right? And I look at it and say, this is interesting because it's just two different models that really are the same model, but just two different segments of the economy.
That's right.
I think that's a nice, clean way to look at it. So now you have your own coffee, you have your own cafe, correct?
That is correct. We have our own.
Where is that located?
It's in Baltimore. It's a place called Spro, S-P-R-O Coffee. You can find us on sprocoffee.com. And we bring in coffee from around the world from different producers that we work with directly and try to find something really interesting and tasty for our guests and customers to try.
So you bring something different to the table than your others. I always wondered, what the hell is it? There's like 12 coffee places inside of a half a mile. What makes them different? So what you're doing is you're adding variety and you're enriching your clientele.
Yes. And it's very much like, let's say, sports ownership, right? You have some sports owners that are, they just want to have a team and they just want to, you know, play the game or maybe even win a few times. But then you have some owners that are very much having a vision about what they want to deliver, what kind of people they want to bring into their organization, both on the back end as well as on the field or on the court. That's really kind of the difference between like any kind of ownership, coffee owners or restaurateurs. The people that have vision to drive and deliver to their guest or to their customer something unique and something hopefully delicious or, you know, winning.
So Jay, you're more of a fulfillment guy that just happens to be in the coffee and cigar business. So you like to make their bellies happy, their brains happy, their senses happy. In fact, we're going to hear a little bit more about that when we come back from commercial break. Folks, we're here with Jay Carrigy of Coffee and Cigars. This guy really knows what he's talking about. I sure as hell don't. Back here in a few minutes of the circus. Lots more to come. Don't go anywhere.
You don't sit behind a desk every day to earn a living. You're out and about making it happen. And sometimes you get a little bit behind on your paperwork, you know, like bookkeeping and paying your taxes. It's easy to get behind on paying your taxes. It happens to the best of us. And you know what happens next. The big bad IRS comes knocking on your door. And when that happens, you need to call the good old boys at the Tax Doctor. Let them do what they do best. Deal and negotiate with the IRS so you pay the lowest you can in back taxes that the law allows. We are a 100% U.S.-based company, and we've saved our clients millions over the years in back taxes. If you owe $10,000 or more in back taxes, call my friends right now at the Tax Doctor and learn more.
800-989-1694. 800-989-1694. 800-989-1694. That's 800-989-1694.
Nobody wants to get ripped off, broken into, or robbed, but nobody wants to pay a lot of money to have their home protected either.
I've got an offer to tell you about to provide home security for your home for less than a dollar a day. For real, with no installation or equipment charges. And this is from a company rated number one by a leading consumer research company. According to the facts, most of you won't even call unless there's a burglary in your neighborhood or something bad happened. So let's give you a reason. Save money. For less than a dollar a day with no other costs, you can get your home secured. Plus, get a lifetime equipment replacement warranty. You need protection for your home. Call the home security hotline right now.
800-361-3491. 800-361-3491. 800-361-3491. Again, that's 800-361-3491.
That's the sound of sizzling, dry-aged USDA Prime Wagyu and Angus steaks from UppercutChops.com. They're best-in-class filet mignons, New York steaks, and the king of all steaks, the tomahawk and cowboy cut ribeyes are the best in the business. Even their Prime Wagyu burgers will likely be the best you've ever had. Browse the full selection of steaks and chops at UppercutChops.com from the comfort of your home or on your mobile device. UppercutChops.com delivers all-natural, dry-aged USDA Prime Wagyu and Angus steaks and chops directly to your door. Without the hassle of going to the grocery store and fight crowds to pick from a small selection of average and best meats with injected steroids, fillers, and coloring added to look good. Find out what's for dinner at UppercutChops.com or call 702-799-9935. That's 702-799-9935. 702-799-9935. Or make your selection directly at UppercutChops.com.
We'll be right back.
to the Sports Circus. I'm your Ringmaster Sal, live from Las Vegas in the AMP TV studio, AAMP.TV. This segment brought to you in part by the Sports Circus. Make sure you check out thesportscircus.com for our upcoming guests, a prior guest, our recorded shows, which are podcasts, of course, recorded in their entirety. We make mistakes all the time. We leave the mistakes in there. You know why? Because we can. That's why. Also, make sure you check out the partners page. And one of the partners that's been with us since the very beginning is the College of Southern Nevada Athletics. CSNCoyotes.com for upcoming games and events. Great tickets, great venues. College of Southern Nevada Athletics. Check them out at CSNCoyotes.com. All right, and welcome back to everybody listening in on our CBS, NBC, and Fox Sports affiliates from coast to coast, Magic 97.9 FM right here in Las Vegas, and of course, Cox, Comcast, Spectrum, Frontier, and WOW Cable TV watchers, as well as hotel television in well over a half million rooms in over 200 markets across the country, and everybody else streaming on Facebook, AMP TV, AAMP.TV. Make sure you like, subscribe, and follow, and everywhere else. We're here with special guest Jay Carrigay of Coffee and Cigars, and thanks for joining us again, Jay.
Oh, thanks for having me, Sal.
All right. So in the last segment, it was more of a coffee get-up dialogue. Now, what about this pairing? Do you actually pair coffee and cigars together?
Oh, we do. We do. Every show, we do that pairing together to find sometimes we get it right, and sometimes we don't get it quite as right.
But how do you know if you got it right? Because it's the taste of each person, right?
It is. And the thing is that, you know, the show itself is really driven by what I'm tasting. And so hopefully it's a guide for people to give it a try and see if it fits their palate. And I think with any kind of reviewer of food, as you're listening or reading to that person, then talking about what they like or what they dislike, if you're trying those same things, you start to figure out, okay, my palate is in line with that person or it's not in line with that person. And that helps you figure out what's good for you.
So what if you're at a sporting event? This is a sports show, right? So let's say you're watching a football game. You're watching your Baltimore Ravens, right? Yes. So you're watching your Baltimore. So here's a little conflict of interest with the Cleveland Browns, right? How about that one? The Cleveland Browns and the Baltimore Ravens, right? So we got the Browns up there, right? And all right, so here you've got Cleveland playing Cleveland, essentially. And so if you're a Cleveland Browns, if you're in Cleveland, what kind of cigar are you smoking saying, you know what, we're playing ourselves over here. But if you're in Baltimore, you're like, hey, we're playing the new version of the Browns, right? I mean, what a conundrum. What does each fan from each team likely smoke?
Well, you know, and that's fascinating. That's a fascinating thing to think about. I would say that the Baltimore fan would smoke a cigar from Tatuaje, this company that's based out in Southern California in Los Angeles.
Are they paying you to say that?
No, well maybe they should. That'd be nice. But send me cigars, Pete. Send me cigars.
Show me the money!
But the Cleveland Browns fan, what would they smoke?
Something probably more aggressive because they're going to be pissed off. They're playing themselves.
Are they pissed off? Are they still pissed off?
Yeah, they're still pissed off.
I guess so. You know, well, I guess that's true because we're still pissed off at Indianapolis. So that makes sense.
There it is. So take it a step further. See, now you can reverse this. And so when the Ravens are playing the Colts, but let's stick with the Browns and the Ravens first.
Okay.
Then you can do a role reversal.
The Browns. So I think the Browns would smoke something. Maybe like Arturo Fuente. Arturo Fuente makes this thing called the Opus X. They probably would smoke something like that. Like you said, they want something to soothe their anger, to soothe their heartbreak. I think that's a good one to go with.
Really? You don't think they would be amped up and want to go the other direction?
We don't have that kind of relationship with the Browns. Like, they're upset with us. We're not so upset with them.
Okay, all right. So now put yourself, hold that thought. Now it's the Ravens and the Colts. Now you're playing yourselves.
Oh, yeah.
What are you going to smoke?
Oh, what would be the gnashing of the teeth cigar? Because that's just a bitter, bitter point in history. Maybe then we would smoke something like the Toscani Di Nobili from Italy, that cheroot type of cigar. It's kind of rough. It's kind of harsh, but it's got a lot of flavor.
So you're going to gnaw on a clove of garlic and smoke that cigar at the same time, right?
When it comes to thinking about the Colts, yeah, probably for sure.
Right. So, you know, the cool thing is you can actually do this rule reversal because those three cities, I mean, what a disaster, right, in the football world. Nonetheless, right, right. By the way, in case you didn't know this, the LA Rams started off where? In Cleveland.
That's right.
The Cleveland Rams 100 years ago. But imagine, you know, you think of these weird matchups, just like we're trying to match up coffee with food and coffee with cigars and cigars with, I don't know, with sex. I mean, you know, people
that's a great will way to cap off
afterwards. Sex. Is there an after sex cigar?
Oh, gosh. I think with anything that you'd like, because once you have that victory, there everything is sweet after that.
Okay. All right. Yeah. So whether it's a Prignus win or a win in the sack, whatever the hell that's it right. is, I don't know. you're going to have a celebratory cigar, but do you have one when you go down an ignominious defeat?
Yes. Yes. You definitely want to have one because that's again, it calms the nerves and just kind of like, you know, you're wallowing in your shame and you need something smooth and gosh, what would be a great one for that? There's a company called Padron. And they make beautiful flavored cigars, and they're kind of expensive. I think they're Padron 1926 for the time when you're like wallowing in your shame. That's the way to.
He said 1926.
Yeah, that's they named it after their grandfather, who I believe was born in 1926.
Well, I'm thinking like a 96-year-old cigar for some reason. I don't know. I'm like, wow, that's really age, isn't it?
I have actually had one that was 70 plus years.
What?
And surprisingly enough, it actually had nice flavor. Like I really couldn't believe it. It was a cigar from the World War II era.
It tastes like 1940.
Yeah, it was, I guess 1940 was a good year. My gosh, it was crazy.
I guess. Well, that'd be 80 years, but 1950. So maybe it was the Fonzie and Happy Days version of the cigar.
Right. It could be.
You know, incidentally, we've already had Poxy and Ralph Melf on this show previously.
Oh, wow. Really? Excellent.
Yeah. Anson Williams, Anson's a great guy. Anson, his kids call him Vanson because he drives a minivan. Right? All the neighborhood kids call him Vanson. I mean, that's what he does. But what a great guy. He's got these things called alert drops, right? Keeps you awake, whatever, all natural, whatever. But Anson's a great guy. He's just got an electric personality where Don Most, as Ralph Melt, was a little bit more subdued, and he is a very serious actor, and he does cabaret singing. I mean, this guy is he's on stage on a regular basis. Oh, it's fantastic. Amazing. And ironically, Ralph Melt was the most athletic out of all of the guys. And I heard that from Potsy or Anson Williams. He said Ron Howard wasn't really much of an athlete, but it was actually Don Most who was the bigger athlete out of all of them. And, you know, you think maybe Fonzie, you know, trying to be cool about stuff, but not a chance.
Yeah, definitely.
I don't even know where we're going with this. What would Fonzie smoke?
Oh, Fonzie smoked cigarettes. He was a cigarette guy.
Yeah, but if he smoked a cigar, what would he smoke?
I think Fonzie would smoke these type of cigars that are small in stature, kind of like similar in size to a cigarette. I think he would smoke something like that. This one brand called Monte Cristo makes them. I think he would probably smoke one of those.
What would Charlton Heston smoke?
Oh, Charlton Heston. Well, he's a commander, so he would want to smoke something a little bit more robust, a little bit more forceful. So for him, I think that he would probably go for, there's this newer cigar called the Crook of the Crown from a company called Stolen Thrones. Very like robust and really flavorful, spicy cigar. I think that would be a good Charlton Heston cigar.
Okay. Now, what about the ladies out there? There's a lot of ladies smoking cigars these days.
Oh, yeah, there's definitely a lot of ladies. And, you know, surprisingly, the ladies that I know that smoke cigars, they actually smoke some pretty heavy-bodied cigars. Like, I'm really, really surprised with what they're smoking out there. It's like, oh, really? You're smoking that? I don't know if I could smoke that.
Wow. Like, well, yeah, because I've seen it here and there. I mean, in our last couple of minutes of the show, I had to bring it up just because it's out there. You know, and the ladies are doing it. And I'm wondering, I mean, if they're going into the cigar clubs and whatnot, because there's a lot of those. And, you know, they're going in there and they're just being one of the guys because, I don't know, they're being one of the guys, or it's just because they really dig it. Maybe it's a little bit of both.
They really dig it. And well, it's interesting because, like, it's kind of funny because cigar guys are kind of funny in this respect, where it's really just a guy's domain mainly. And so when a woman comes, it's kind of like a woman at the comic book store, right? Everyone's kind of like, there's a woman here. Now we're like, oh wow, who's that? We're all fascinated. And guys are also like, now we have to like clean up our act. Like we have to sit up straight, you know, right. Fix our shirt, you know, look a little more presentable than the slobs we tend to be at the lounge.
Right. Yeah. It's kind of a conundrum. Hey, listen, we've got about another minute or so left. Tell everybody all about your show and how they could follow you and everything else.
All right. Great. So my name is Jay Carrigan. I have a show called Coffee and Cigars on YouTube every Thursday night, 8 p.m. Eastern. We're on the Ono Live channel, O-N-O-L-I-V-E. We do it every Thursday night. So come join us. We always like to talk coffee and cigars. And if you'd like to follow me on Instagram, I'm at Ono Coffee, O-N-O Coffee with the number 4. And that's the best way to reach out to me.
Ono Coffee 4. Mm-hmm. What's with the 4? How can I stop for you?
Well, I used to have the Ono Coffee handle on Instagram. And then someone hacked my accounts on Facebook and it wiped everything out. And so I had to restart and they wouldn't give me back my name. So I just arbitrarily chose 4.
So you think, Jay, that we're going to be able to find you on possibly on the radio right here in Las Vegas at some point? Ooh,
that would be fine, exciting. I'd love that.
I think you could do one or two nights a week and it would be fun. Maybe, I don't know, in the evening hours and people kind of sit back when they get off of work and say, you know, there's that guy, Jay. He taught me a little bit about coffee and cigars. And, you know, I'm kind of digging the cigar side. So I want to tune in and I'm going to listen in. And what's your YouTube channel again?
It's called Ono Live, O-N-O-L-I-V-E, on YouTube every Thursday night, 8 p.m.
That's good stuff. Well, listen, Jay, it's been a pleasure. And listen, I don't know anything about coffee and cigars, and I think I learned a little bit tonight. So that's always a good bit of news whenever I learn something. Awesome. Thank you for that.
Thank you. I'm so glad to be here. I'm so thankful for you to invite me onto your show. It's been a really
wonderful. And I see your light in the background. Everybody on TV can see it says coffee.
It says coffee. In case you're wondering, like what I do for a living.
Right. Well, just in case you're keeping score, you may want to put that a little bit off the side so everybody can actually see it.
There we go.
Because you're kind of blocking. You're your own worst nightmare with that. You're blocking your sign.
I know. I need to
chuck it over. I know. But hey, thanks for joining us again today. Big round of applause for Jay Carrigan of Coffee and Cigars. And we'll see you next time right here on your favorite station in about 23 hours. Until then, so long, everyone.
Business owner or pursuing the dream of starting your own company? Do you know where to start or how to grow that existing business? The American Business Trust Company has the answers you need. The American Business Trust Company can help you start up with capital, business strategy, sales, and marketing, and establish your company with a physical location or an online presence on the internet. You decide. You bring the idea. Then American Business Trust can help with the rest. For a free evaluation, visit them online at abtrustco.com. That's abtrustco.com. Or call them at 657-600-1876. That's American Business Trust Company, 657-600-1876. Call them today. They'll help your business right away. That's American Business Trust Company. Online at abtrustco.com. American Business Trust Company.